The last time they were here, that's what you performed the last time.
Yeah.
How lovely to see you. Welcome back.
Thank you for having us back.
And it's a shame that you overdressed for us.
Well, we planned it for you.
Don't we all?
Especially. They are the most amazing. You've got to come in and get the clothes off some of these because they are amazing. With corsets and sequins.
Rhinestones galore.
They're really comfortable to sit in.
I love it.
Nicole, I can't, there's no room for your internal organs. Where are your intestines?
It's usually tighter. This is the looser one, so I can sit down.
Everything is above or below.
They all move up and down.
Before we came back out here, the girl who's doing my corset, she grabs the string and she puts her knee in my back and pulls the opposite way. And you're like, oh. It's like back in the old days.
But they then expect you to not only sing, but dance in there.
Oh, yeah.
How is that physically?
There's not really enough room for your ribs to expand, so you can't really breathe. Yeah. You just have to hold your breath and hope everything comes out.
Hopefully you won't fall down.
You take short breaths when you're singing.
Exactly, yeah.
When you're singing, you just like, really take a short breath. You're really excited, a lot of energy.
Constantly in danger of hyperventilating. Yeah.
Have you ever fainted?
I feel like it every day.
Every night, especially in Don't You, I do this one note, and I'm still, by the grace of God, wondering when I'm going to faint on stage.
Yeah.
I feel like my face is actually turning blue, like in the cartoons, and I'm like, hold it.
Well, I was saying to Melody earlier on, though, just when you came in, that the thing is that we're being so strapped in. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're almost explosive, isn't it? Because if you were to fall, it would just.
Well, that is
going every direction.
Yeah. The secret to doll domination.
Yeah. Yeah. So talking of doll domination, this is you're on your start of your European tour. You kicked off in Scotland here, going off to Europe. So how many kind of costume changes and things do you have? What can we expect to see?
At least five. There are lots of costume changes. But you know, we always say fashion goes hand in hand with music. So we have different styles and vibes for different sets and some of the songs that we do.
Yeah. We're super excited because this is the biggest show that we've really been able to do so far. And it's our second world tour, Doll Domination. And we've just really put our heart and souls into everything. There's lots of production and explosions and costumes and rhinestones, so we're just excited.
Yeah, our shows are sold out, so that is just amazing.
What a lovely thing. How lovely to be able to come on and do an interview. I mean, we're going to talk about, obviously, you know, we've talked about the album before and the new single, which you're going to do for us in a bit. But when it comes to, you know, big arena tours, and I wrote down how many you were doing here, something like 17 countries, 25 American states, that's, you know, sort of 72 concerts. I don't think I've even included Asia. You know, so you've got all that sort of stuff. But how lovely not to have the pressure of really having to sell them. They just sort of sell themselves.
Yeah. We're so blessed. We have the best fans. They wait outside our hotel rooms, and they're so loving, and they make
us feel
special.
Some people would find that frightening.
I walked out yesterday and had a fan from Australia, the one who made us scrapbooks, flew from Australia here.
And it takes 24 hours, doesn't it?
And to give me another scrapbook. And these are amazing things that I'm going to keep for the rest of my life.
How do you keep up that energy? Because the dance routines you do are phenomenal. And these tours and every night.
We have a secret. Our chef makes this banoffee pie.
I don't believe you've been eating banoffee pie.
There is no banoffee pie in there. I do not believe that.
If you eat a little bit of the banoffee pie, actually a whole piece, which I do, before you go on stage, you have a lot of energy. And then if you start to lose energy, you think about the banoffee pie that you're going to eat after.
The single, what do you think about that, is interesting because we were, once again, we were talking before you sat down, that it suddenly struck us that you've worked a lot with guys, but because that you're working with Missy Elliott here, is this the first time you've worked recently with a lady?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, we work with a lot of female writers.
Yeah.
But this is one of our first female special guests. So she's, and what a special guest, what a featured artist is she? She's a true pussycat doll. Missy Elliott is the bomb. Mm-hmm.
Is she scary?
No. She lights up a room.
Oh my gosh, she's so precious.
Mm-hmm. She's so shy.
Is she?
Yep. She's like a little puppy.
She's shy.
She's really shy. Yeah.
She's done so much, like put out so many amazing songs. Like we've grown up like listening to her stuff. So the fact that we got to work with her and she was so cool, it was really refreshing to meet somebody who's done so much in their lives and still be humble.
Well, the single's been described as a ferocious club track.
Dope.
About a deadbeat guy.
Oh my God.
Yeah,
just,
there's a lot of them out there.
There's a lot of them out there.
There's a lot of them.
Is anybody looking out for your girls?
So do we have is there a deadbeat guy? Is someone who, you know, this is the...
I feel like we've all been through them.
Yeah.
We've been across a few.
We help each other through them, and then hopefully we'll find that gem.
Prince Charming.
My guy's not deadbeat, though. I do have to put that out there.
Your guy's definitely not deadbeat.
Well,
you know very well. And the thing is that... because we are all massive F1 fans, of course. Mm-hmm. And so, I've written down a single question about personal stuff. I just want to talk about the next season. And how is he in training?
He's in training.
Is he feeling confident? He gave us the most exciting time ever. And we're talking about Lewis Hamilton, by the way, here, just in case you know. But is he so training intensely now?
He's training right now, and we're just... He knows what to do. He's got the best team behind him, and I think he's just getting used to the new car.
Well, there's a lot of, there's a lot made of the actual driving, but I mean, of all Formula One drivers, I think it's often forgotten that these guys are really quite serious athletes and unbelievably fit.
Well, then when they train, I believe my understanding is they train like Olympics train, the Olympians train, so it's pretty intense.
Yeah.
But it's almost not as intense as...
He's not as fast as I am when we run and dance and
well,
stuff.
Well, and that's what we'll do. I mean, I'm happy enough with that. When you see him, will you tell him that we're big fans?
Most definitely. I always do like glass.
Well, listen, he might be doing athletic training, but you girls certainly do. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful, wonderful tour. And I know when you go back to the States, you're going to be supporting Britney Spears on her first tour in 5 years.
How did that feel to be told that was
huge? Because, you know, I actually was a big fan of Britney growing up, and then we're going to be performing in Miami where I saw her. We're going to be opening for her in the same arena that I went to go see her. So it's just fantastic. An honor.
Well, When I Grow Up, she was in the video, wasn't she?
Yeah, originally.
So just between us, when you see her, how is she going to feel that she was cut out of the final version?
You know what, she's been in this business longer than we have, just as long, if not longer, like I said, and so she understands that that's just part of the business. It wasn't our choice, it wasn't a personal thing. We're fans of her, we love and support her, so it's just great that we get to be on tour together and then hopefully do a song in the future together.
Well, she's in better shape now as well, isn't she, which is great.
Right.
It looks like that's come together.
Our new video is amazing, too, the circus one.
We just hope to bring a lot of light and love to her life. You know, she's been through so much, and it's just awesome to have a bunch of females come together and really put on a good show.
Doing it for the girls.
Doll Domination.
Because we know that you exec produced Doll Domination, so are you looking at this as well? Is this something else that you want to do?
Well, I love producing. I mean, I was able to help executive produce with Ron Fair and the other producers, Timbaland and stuff. So I love producing, and maybe I'll get to produce some of the other girls' stuff sometime in the future. I just love music, so anyway, I can get my hands on it.
What's she like as a producer? Is she difficult?
She's
bossy?
She's bossy.
Nicole. Listen, if she annoys you, just go behind and tighten up her corset.
Listen, guys, thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. Always
a pleasure, and you're going to sing for us in a bit.
Yeah.
So thank you very much indeed.
Great.
Thanks a lot.